In a small riverside town some 60 kilometers northwest of Montreal, Maurice Guindon and his wife head out to meet friends for dinner. Leaving their teenage son Yvan in charge of the house.
Yvan Guindon was a 13-year-old boy who was babysitting his two younger sisters. He was described by friends and parents as a good kid who never seemed to get into trouble, was very responsible, and not prone to making up wild stories.
But his kids' sisters are determined not to make his job so easy. Later, with the girls finally asleep, the house is dead quiet. But not for long.
Shortly after 11 o'clock at night, there was a sudden explosion of noise.
Sort of a buzzing, whirring noise, almost like a transformer noise, an electrical kind of noise, which had seemed odd.
Yvan is pretty sure that whatever it is, his sisters are probably behind it.
He thought maybe the television had been left on. But it was not.
The noise is coming from somewhere. And Yvan isn't the only one to hear it.
Outside in the yard, the family dog was barking and yowling in a very unusual manner.
He notices a bright light coming from the bathroom.
He notices some sort of illumination. Having been left with the responsibility of looking after his two young sisters, he started to worry a little bit about what was going on.
Yvan is concerned he may be dealing with an intruder.
Through the window, he saw a very bright light.
But it's more than just a light.
He saw that it was actually an object partly hidden in the trees about 15 or 20 feet in the air. He heard the sound of what he thought was branches breaking.
And it appeared to, rather ominously for him, seem to be moving sort of closer to the house. And this obviously started to concern him.
Yvan immediately feels weak and disoriented.
As Yvan was watching this object, he said that he broke out in goosebumps as if the object itself was having some effect on his body.
Did it mean harm to him and his family? He didn't know.
Yvan? Yann, Denise, cache-toi! Cache-toi!
Started to observe this strange beam of light that seemed to slowly project from the bottom of the object.
Yvonne had the impression that this beam of light was somehow looking for something down on the ground.
Suddenly, this beam of light hit him in the face.
Holy shit!
He could no longer see. He was blind. Accompanying this blindness was a sort of a very, very strong headache.
Slowly, Yvonne starts to regain his sight.
Sort of overcome with disorientation, he's trying to figure out what's happening, where he is. Trying to figure out what's going on.
It took him quite a few minutes to regain composure again. The object was still there, but had taken on a completely different appearance. What he saw was that the object was now embedded inside a curtain or a bell jar of transparent light.
Like a dome over the top of the object.
Perhaps the air itself was electrically charged by the object. Perhaps it was giving off some sort of electromagnetic field. And that was how Yvonne was able to see this bell jar or electrical effect.
This kind of phenomenon is known as St. Elmo's fire. Similar to lightning, it's a weather event in which ionized air glows around trees and other pointed objects.
The fact that this was so structured around the object sort of goes way beyond that kind of natural explanation. Then all of a sudden, this bell jar effect seemed to disappear.
And the object gets ready for takeoff.
As if an engine was revving up. The object zips away and is suddenly gone in a fraction of a second.